This is Fatima from Vizag Web News. First of all, I would like to ask you something. Do you know how many types of handlooms India has been represented to the world right now? Wait, let me count first. That is Panchampalli from Andhra Pradesh and Odisha has been represented Bomkoi. And if I'll count like this, it will be a long list. Yes, that is true. It will be a long list because India has been represented her tradition and the culture in a long list. So that shows that India has been a rich in that culture and heritage. So proud to be an Indian. So the topic of today is this. Handloom Week. So right now we are in St. Joseph College for Women Autonomous, where Home Science Department is celebrating Handloom Week from 7th to 12th of August. As we know that 7th of August has been declared as the National Handloom Day, so we came to know that St. Joseph College is celebrating this day from the last year. So the main motto of celebrating this week is to spread awareness about the handloom industries and the importance of handloom industries as a part of Indian culture and heritage. You will be glad to know that 43 lakh peoples of India has been engaged in handloom sector. So that's a great number. So we can say that handloom is at national level. So let us check out now and get more knowledge about handlooms by checking out the activities which these people have been done today. Now, I am very curious to know more about handloom that shows our Indian tradition and culture. So let us talk something about handloom and get more knowledgeable from these Home Science Department students. Now, she'll tell us about which type of handloom this is and which state this is belonging to.
This is Nellore's Venkatagiri sari, Venkatagiri handloom. The speciality of this handloom is it is the zari used in these saris is coated with pure gold or silver. In olden days, these saris were only worn by the richest, zamindars, and the queens. So that is the speciality of this sari. That's it.
So what are you now explaining about which sari it is?
Pochampalli. Pochampalli sari is also known as Pochampalli ikat. It is a traditional garment. This type of silk is originated in the town Bodhan Pochampalli. This type of sari is interlaced first warp yarns and weft yarns, and then the design comes. Geometrical pattern. These saris are mainly geometrical pattern. These saris are very lightweight to handle very easily, comfortable also.
Now the student is going to be explain what type of sari it is and what are the speciality of it.
These are the minor handlooms of AP and Telangana. Each has its own and unique features. That is, first sari is Uppada, and it has its own features. And Uppada is of many types, like Uppada silk and Uppada cotton. Uppada is a district in Kakinada. It belongs to Kakinada district. And this is Dharmavaram. Dharmavaram has its own unique features, like booties, and booties are different from here. And this is Chirala, and this is Uppada cotton. these are the main handlooms of AP and Telangana. And Telangana covers, that is Narayanpet. Narayanpet has its own features, and it has like zari will be in gold, and mostly it will be in gold. And this is Bobbili saris. Bobbili saris belongs to as it is in the names. Bobbili state has its saris.
Tell me something about which sari it is and what are the speciality over here.
We have taken the project about khadi. You are familiar with the khadi, right? From Gandhiji movement, he was promoted the khadi, and this is the khadi. You are all you all know about khadi shirts. This is the khadi shirt. Yeah, because we know about khadi only about shirts, but we can find khadi not only shirts. That we can find saris also. This is a sari. This is a pure khadi sari, and khadi is made up of pure cotton, and the cotton is refined with fish bone to remove fluffy and it to become smooth in the sari. And this is the khadi panch lungi dhoti. This is a towel, and this is the khadi, pure khadi sari. And this is the main costume uniform for Avinash Lingam University. So you all know about the importance of khadi. And this is a khadi pant, and this is half cotton and half silk. This is khadi silk, and this is a pure khadi ponduru silk. Ponduru is near Srikakulam district, and that is also khadi, and this is khadi, pure khadi silk. So that's it, and that is the process of khadi spinning. This is purely handmade weaving. This is not machine made, only with handmade. That's
all. So this was all about the culture and heritage which our Indians have been followed, and this was all varieties of sarees which shows our tradition. So that's all for today.